All right, guys, we are live here for our fifth Bowman multi-case break. Good luck, everyone. We'll start with the hobby case. Good luck, guys. Freaking Tommy Two Guns. Unbelievable. First one I've ever pulled. Ever. Is that any good? In a BOGO? All right, guys, good luck. Teams are on the right-hand side. Unbelievable. Brady Auto.
No Cespedes, and it's just, they're a different team. know what happens in New York, but everybody that goes to the Mets seems to get hurt, including myself. Wow, you're forcing me to bring up a follow-up question here, Pedro. You played for the New York Mets.
Yes.
Did you feel like there was this weird play any older yeah. the New York Mets roster?
Is he in anything?
We had everything going. We work hard, we did whatever, but somehow, when it goes to the Mets, it goes to the Mets. It's unbelievable. The nucleus I saw when we came to the kitchen,
Tommy Two Guns. Stanton Purple.
This is where we got to give credit. You know who we got to give credit to? Jacob DeGrom. Takes the ball every day. He's the one I know. We got the Dark Knight. We got Thor. We got all the Marvel Comics guys out there. And Jacob DeGrom is the one that goes in.
You let go on the old goal, Bartolo Colon, and he would have been huge. He never let go of the ball either. He was the most consistent starter they had, and they got rid of him to supposedly have the other seven starters that they have, and it hasn't.
Well, it also shows you need some luck on your side. You know, you do what the Chicago Cubs did last year when they had the same five guys start every fifth day.
Yeah, that's unheard of.
Right?
Absolutely.
We did the same thing in 04, and we ended up having the same results.
Austin Voth, Blue Refractor.
So Cleveland, to break their curse. So you guys broke in 04, the Cubs broke. So in order to break
Black Gold, curse, 15 Black Gold.
Starter on the deal. Good luck.
You need them to pitch as much as they can.
Yeah, and that's not happening. Let's move on to the Miami Marlins, taking on Lomo and the Rays. And Logan Morrison is a new man again. I know that sounds redundant, but he's back to being the early Logan Morrison. They were like, this guy could be a 30-homer first baseman. Another ball for him. If you look at what Steven Souza Jr. has been doing, getting on base at a rapid pace, Edison Volpe.
Dylan Cease. Dylan Cease, Blue Shimmer.
A crazy stat line. I'm going to give it to you in a minute. Meanwhile, bases loaded. Tim Beckham, fly ball, track down, RBI. Kiermaier scores. Beckham's looking good in play right now.
Yes, he sure is.
This is the town up to the throw. So it's 3-0. They go to the bullpen because Volquez was just too erratic. Gallon comes in to get the punch out. Volquez is the first pitcher in the modern era since 1900 with nine
Gary Pettis.
Eight or more walks in a game with fewer than five innings pitched. How about that?
Woo, doggy! For the Cubbies! Wow. Bobby the Whale Shark!
John Lester doesn't have a win yet.
Starting off on the right foot, Whale Shark!
The wheel is right. Are you worried about it?
I'm not.
Those Altair going yard. This is Chris Bryant's fifth of the year, Mike. Because he's about to get hot. It was like a little rough 2 weeks, and then boom. It's gonna be 30 plus, guaranteed monster year once again. This guy could be 30 plus. Javi Baez. Here's a Tommy Joseph shoots this the other way. Michael Saunders on first, good athlete, rounds the bases easily. Phillies tied up at two. Kyle Schwarber. Oh my. Do the Cubs have basically four guys where it's like must-see TV on their at-bats?
I would
like, agree. I'm Bryant for sure.
Rizzo.
Schwarber.
Yeah.
And Baez. Nothing again. I mean, they still got Addison Russell and Rizzo. They have a lot of good. But just the way those guys did must-see TV for those guys.
Like, they have bad things in their team.
Here we go. Más intención. To that, because take it to the kids that might be talking, that I'm watching tonight. I tell my son, 40-year-old team, anyone can hit the baseball, but you gotta do damage. You gotta look for the person who can do damage.
is. I want you just to look for a ball to see if you can put the bat on it.
Now, aren't
and
you worried about
overswinging though when you try to put that? No, because when they take batter practice and then they make that swing and they drive it in the gap, and you say doing damage isn't really swinging as hard as you can. It's looking for a certain hit, a certain location, whatever it might be. Now, if one way always fly off that thing in terms of being a football player, it's the same. You see Schwarber, he's not.
Nah, not yet, Neil. I gotta get it. What's up, Omaha? $288 packs in a hobby case, man. It kills me. Why do you think I'm running contests for the boxes? It's just unbelievable. Justin Bour, purple, number to 250.
Yeah, let's not go dynasty around like
no, dynasty.
Powerhouse and dynasty are two different.
How do you
that's
play?
Only dynasty and championships. For me, would you say the Atlanta Braves were a dynasty? I say they were a perennial playoff contender. And the reason I don't say dynasty is because they won one World Series when they lost their postseason 12 times in a row.
Right side of your screen, it's the Indians and the Tigers quickly in the ninth. Two outs. K-Rod trying to put the finishing touches.
Nice. Jose Pujols blue auto for the Phillies for Sean Dunleavy. Jose Pujols blue auto number to 150 for Sean Dunleavy.
Those are about to be one of probably the best dynasty in baseball. And the owner didn't want them winning. Imagine that.
I wouldn't even go that far. I don't think three in a row. If you told me the Yankees won three out of
five. Don't talk to me, Whale Shark.
When we look back, we could say the Giants dynasty, but it seemed like they did it with new personnel every year. And once again, I don't think they were considered even the best team in their
game. Andy Ibanez, red 70th paper.
Based on the situation, he gives just one run and still a 6-3 lead. We go to the action in Comerica. Tigers up.
What's up, Jamie?
And they're one strike away from beating their division rival, the first place Cleveland Indians. Justin Verlander. Holy. Sniffing a win.
Taylor Ward, purple refractor, number to 250. Yeah, isn't that the truth? The guy just can't get through an inning without giving up a base runner. It's unbelievable. I got mad respect for K-Rod, though, man. This guy has reinvented himself. Who knows how many times. Guy used to throw heat, 97. Now he's throwing change-ups. Like...
Bullpen area is 6.9. Right now, it's the worst bullpen.
bullpen ERA in baseball.
I mean, even Valverde saved 45 games when they need, it was like two runners on every time. What is it about? I mean, I feel terrible for Brad Austin. Like, that's gray hair is coming a lot faster than it should be coming.
That's a really good point. It's like, it's part of the...
Daz Cameron, blue shimmer. Daz Cameron, blue shimmer.
I'm saying that, but it's true. Now, as I say that, K-Rod, oh, that looked awkward.
Jesus, God.
K-Rod had a 2.21 ERA a couple years ago. That was with Milwaukee. Last year, 3.24 ERA.
Which, I'm 44 saves.
Yeah, we're not criticizing K-Rod last year. No. I take it. 44 saves in a 3. Okay.
You know, sometimes it takes a bold move. Like, I remember it sounded really bad because the player that got traded in 04 was Nomar Garciaparra, and everybody was like, oh, you're playing Nomar, are you crazy? But it ended up leading us to a better defense. We ended up...
This guy can't throw a strike. Series,
and I'm not taking anything away from Nomar. Believe me, I think we were destined to win it. We were going to win it. But I never heard of the best player to win. He just fit better, and sometimes I feel like teams like Detroit, they could just make a bold move and trade someone or shake up something. You can't be in the same type of problems all year. Same thing for the Mets. Why is everybody getting hurt? You need to really, really beat.
There's some organizational accountability that you're saying.
You need to, I don't know, shake up something. Switch.
He's throwing. He's pumping it in there at 88. There you go. Yeah, tell me about it, Omaha. Are you in the break or are you just hanging out, brother? Jesus, God, can K-Rod get out of this? Please. I don't have a store, man. I got everything's on Facebook. Everything is on Facebook. If you're on Facebook, send a request to join. Everything fills really fast. Got a great group. We do a ton of baseball. Are you on Facebook, Omaha? I don't know what that means, man.
Talent away for a premier closer, a super relief pitcher. At what point will it be the Detroit Tigers?
Right. I don't. I don't know what that means. You guys buy into breaks together or what? I don't get it.
K-Rod needs that pitch. Tying runs coming to the plate. You know it's coming to the plate, right? Francisco Lindor.
How does he walk him right there?
Lindor represents the tying run, two outs in the ninth.
Let's listen in. Gold Shimmer, good luck, guys. Grant Holmes, Gold Shimmer for the A's. Grant Holmes, Gold Shimmer for the A's. 19 out of 50. Runner breaks to second, and a ball low, blocked by Avila. They'll put runners at second. Nice orange paper here, Willie Calhoun, number 25. Willie Calhoun. Suburbs of Philadelphia. Right outside of Philadelphia.
Frankie got a couple of quick outs, a ground out, a strikeout, then Gomes, the number 9 hitter, double to right.
Wayne Gomes double. That's the guy that wants to aggravate me, Wayne Gomes. Jan Gomes. Jan friggin' Gomes. As usual, Frankie can't throw a strike. He's like confused. He's forgotten how to throw strikes.
Michael Brantley on deck.
Chance Adams, refractor, number 499. Oh my God, he's very much so.
Lindor tonight has been on base once, a walk, otherwise 0 for 3.
Woo, doggy! How you doing? Arroyo gold joint.
Here's the 2-1. Swing.
For Troy, talk about a welcome back.
Four
out of 50. Congrats, man. Awesome card.
And once again, Francisco has it down to
gold joint.
Here's the 2-2.
Gold paper, Andrew Sopko. Thanks, Omaha.
That's right. Now, guys, this is a tweet from Pete Abraham. And Manny Machado ripped the Red Sox. Quote, I've lost all respect for the organization, he said. We will hear portions of that profanity-laden tirade with plenty of beeps throughout it. Coming up on the day, from Hanley. Why? Because he hit two bombs in this game at Fenway. Lots to get to after the break in the Line of Cougars MLB Tonight post-game show.
The Line of Cougars post-game show is presented by Line of Cougars Summer Shandy, combining German-style light beer with natural ice cream. This is a fresh, refreshing drink. Welcome to the Mighty Side.
Line of Cougars Summer Shandy combines German-style ice beer with the taste of the time. This is refreshing.
Yes, I did.
Where is it?
It was right next to the, right on the envelope, next to the pen. It's right on the envelope. They don't like watching these breaks with lots of packs, man.
Deal.
The double stack and the 4 for 4. A deal so great.
Nobody's talking to you.
Meet the product development team at Turtle Wax, experts in everyday odors and brains behind new Power Up, a game-changing stain and odor-busting line featuring new OdorX technology. Advanced technology that doesn't just mask stains and odors. It eradicates every particle at a molecular level for up to 30 days.
Molecular?
Yes, Katie, molecular. Stains out, odors out, thanks to Power Up. Turtle Wax, trusted innovation inside and out.
Oh, I just bought a hybrid car, the Psionic that you see.
They don't want to watch. They just want to see the recap and go to the next break. See the recap and go to the next break. Tristan, what's up, man? Where the hell you been? That's awesome. Christian Stewart. Number 250. What's up, Abate?
He was again. And Manny Machado, not happy at all. 2-2 pitch later in the inning. And later in the at bat, he strikes out. After the game, he had a lot to say about this, starting with Gary Thorne. Listen.
For that organization in Boston and how they're handling the whole situation, and if they're gonna hit me, hit me. Go ahead, get it over with. Don't keep lingering it around and doing that. You know, I've lost mad respect for that team and that organization.
Did you expect that tonight?
I did not expect it at all. I don't expect anything when I go into the games, and you know, first pitch goes out there 98, but you know, behind your back. I mean, what are you supposed to think?
Home run feels good.
Oh, it always feels good. They feel great when you square them up and you hit them hard.
Now what? I mean, what do you think? Where are we with this?
I don't know. I mean, we'll just have to find out tomorrow and see. They're probably going to try to hit me again, once again. So, you know, I'm just going to have to wear it and see what happens. And you know, if I got to take care of business on my own, then I'm going to have to do something.
What was your thoughts on that pitch game behind you?
What do you think? Probably stuff. I mean, that's stuff that you want to do. But, I mean, I'm not on that side. I'm not on that organization. They're still thinking about that same slide that I did. That was no intention on hurting anybody. And you know, I'm still paying. I'm still trying to get hit at, get thrown out of my head, get thrown out everywhere. And I've lost my respect for the organization, for that coaching staff, for everyone over there. I mean, if you're gonna hit me. Go ahead, hit me. No, don't let this keep lingering around and you know, keep trying to hit people. Just, I hope you should do something about hit pitchers out there with balls in their hands, throwing 100 miles per hour, trying to hit people. I had a bat too. I could go up there and crush somebody if I wanted to. But you know what? I'll get suspended for the year, and the pitchers only get suspended for 2 games.
What's up, Lee?
That's not cool. That's not my call.
I posted who wanted what, man. I can't. I even posted. I'll get you in the list, but I didn't. You weren't on any of the interest posts, man. I'm sorry. I didn't remember. You must have inboxed it to me. Whitley Purple, number 250.
For me, as I see it, is that I slid into second base normal, and then I, you know, kind of hurt someone a little bit, you know, unintentional. I grabbed them after the matter of fact, and you know, they're still trying to pay the piper. I don't know what they're trying to pay for. I don't know what their mindset is. So, I mean, whatever. I'm just gonna keep playing baseball, doing what I gotta do, keep winning games out here, keep playing for my team, and that's all I can show.
Eric Fetty, gold paper, number 250.
Wow. Manny Machado's fed up. And you could say that the Red Sox are in his head and it's working. But the issue is he keeps hitting a home run every night. So
is it really working?
It's not working.
It's phenomenal, man.
He is thinking about it and he's fed up. Both of you guys have a take on this. Pedro, where do you stand on what Chris Sale did tonight?
Wow, nice.
Throwing behind.
Ronald Acuna, refractor auto. Ronald Acuna, refractor auto.
There isn't going to be anything that's going to probably pass by undetected. And
hey.
Yesterday, Mookie Betts
hey.
got
it.
He's a third place hitter. Machado
okay.
is a third place
15
hitter.
15 was the...
For
can you go upstairs?
Yeah, what do you need?
So they decided they were going to put a stop to it.
Can you go upstairs and edit the list? Somebody claimed Baltimore.
This is not
go up and edit the PYT5 list. Go review it.
Maybe it is, but it's going to be on the lower part, and I want to get it over with.
Baltimore Marlins. They're both taken. I just don't know who took them. Acuna, refractor auto. 272 out of 499. I didn't do it, Dan. I was too friggin' exhausted, and our friends were in from Canada, and I had to spend time with them.
What happens to Machado is he's not expecting first to be thrown at by Sale. And this pitch works on Machado's bat right away. The intense look, the way he, you know, the guy he has on top of the mound, he knows he cannot mess around with him because he would do it. He was thrown at. You know, a long ball behind his head, which I don't really agree with. But definitely, these pitches, the next two at bats, work into Machado's head. Those are the afterthoughts of what happened in the first inning. He doesn't look really comfortable in any of the first two at bats. Now, when the game rolls over, and the game becomes known when everything is said and done, well, Machado went back to hit. And that happened, he had a homer. So, I don't have a
problem. You're okay with this,
Christopher. It's okay because it didn't have any intention to harm anybody. And he did it in a professional way. And that was it. That's it. After that, he pitched Machado normal. He pitched everybody else normal. And everything started down after the movie. But, you know,
is Machado off pace for what he just said?
Machado feels too late. Because what he did, not because the persecution he's getting. And I can relate to that. But definitely, it's getting to his mind. It's getting Machado off his normal patient kind of mood that he's always in. And he's thinking about something. He's right now thinking about maybe charging him out or doing something on his own. Which is something I think the team needs to address. The team needs to take care of. Maybe wait for another moment and make Machado understand that he's not going to get anything good by probably charging him out, getting hurt out there, not too valuable to the team. They need him too much.
I don't like it from any standpoint. And I mean, I have tremendous respect for the Red Sox organization, tremendous respect for Manny Machado. Clear how deep it is there. Okay, so let's start with the slide. So you slid in, the spikes came up a little bit. So you can tell by his immediate reaction that he hopes Pedroia, hey, you all right? I get it. If Pedroia leaves for two games, I don't mind the next guy coming in, drilling in the back, done. Guess what? Matt Barnes, you had your chance. You missed. It was 98 at the head. That is not right. Now you see Rodriguez, an expert. It's three balls that you missed. That's four in a row. They had this. I saw the rundown today. We have Pedroia. We have Machado. We have David Robinson. The whole world was on talking about this. Everyone was like, no, it's done. We're good. Everyone's doing the full baseball. Now, the message for the mental part of it, for sale one. I get it. But it's the running back. I'm not a big fan of 3-for-3. I get it. Three-hole hitter, you move your best hitter, you have a three-hole hitter. But let's understand the situation. Three-hole hitter is Manny Machado. He's got four already out. If you guys can't hit a guy with four pitches, guess what? You're done. You look like fools. So what happens? First thing I was like, I got the first time back, you punch him out. Second time he punched out, why? Because Chris Sale punches guys out. Third time back, he knocks him out. You know, so then I give credit to Manny Machado because, like you said,
pitcher. He charges, and he comes in, and I'm telling you, I always say,
how the Giants score.
I go with the helmet. I'm throwing the helmet at the pitcher. So he's so mad. If he does something like that and cracks Chris Sale's nose open, he's going to get some.
What are you talking about, Bobby?
Yeah.
So what did he do then? So I give him credit. I'd rather have the rant in the post-game interview than on the field. But I agree. Like, what do you want me to do? You want Zach Britton to come in and throw 97 now and hit three of your guys? Because it might come down to that, and then someone's going to get really hurt. If you told me from the beginning this was something done with bad intentions and Pedroia got hurt, Pedroia knows he didn't do it. He's the first.
Only a couple boxes in, brother. Not yet. No Twins.
So now I got a feeling that this might.
Bo Bichette, purple, number the 250.
There's a chance this didn't even come from John Farrell. Maybe this was Chris Sale saying, I'm going to show you I'm backing my guy, which that point I respect. I just think you can't do it on Manny Machado in this situation. There's been too much hyped up. So now what do you do if you're Baltimore? Do you retaliate? Because like I said, Chris Sale won. You know why? The warning now kills the other kid. Because now he can't come in. What does he do? A little slider away. Hanley took you to the bridge twice.
Right.
Like, it changes the mentality of the whole game. And that's where I'm like, I feel what Manny Machado feels, the frustration. Like he says, hit me once. You miss four times, guess what, man? You had your chance. That's it.
Awesome. Well done, both of you. Entertaining to listen to it.
Let's go, Luke. Show me something.
Blue Jays out of the final out, and that's a strike.
Hey, Mikey, for the first time I've seen you kind of mad.
I just, man, you know, like, don't get me wrong. I side with the Red Sox almost on everything, man. It was one of the best 5 years of my life. And I'm in favor. We did it. You throw inside the David twice, or he gets hit, your guy's going down. But we had guys like Shill and other guys that did it. And did it right. One pitch, you're done. If you miss, guess what? That was your chance. You missed.
Move on.
You missed. You're bad enough. You can dot the corners, but you can't hit him. You can't hit a guy in the back. I'm sorry. You're done.
This is down the line. Let's listen in.
By Headley, the throw is high and over the head of Carter. So Manley will reach.
We've seen a little bit of this from Chase Headley.
Hey, did somebody reserve the Orioles for the Marlins? Because I don't see anybody claiming them in the throw.
Michael Booth took the Orioles, didn't he?
Backhand.
Urseg refractor, number 2499.
I see the leader's comment.
Almost a self-defense
snag. I looked on the
to bring up Morales. That's the fifth error for Headley. A couple of years ago he had 23. Then he cut him down last year, but now 5. So from 23 to 10 last year and now 5 after a month and 2 days. And he's been fielding the ball great, except the throws seem to be getting away every now and then. Also, he doesn't have Mark Teixeira to save some of those errors.
Do you want to message him?
No, he did take my shirt.
Where do you see it? I don't see it.
A gold glove first baseman.
How come I don't see it?
But I don't think Teixeira could have gotten that one. Maybe Judge could have gotten that one.
Michael Booth, huh?
Ball center field, this should do it. Hicks is there, and it does do it as the Yankees win this one 11-5 and snap their mini two-game losing streak. Another big night for Aaron Judge. Jonathan Holder.
Orioles available at the bottom, but up top, you told them the teams that were open and Orioles wasn't part of it, so I stopped
the
there.
Yankees as they improved to 16-9.
Have a look at those of you watching the action there in the Bronx.
You took
the
Reds.
First time
in the game, 11-5.
The Blue Jays' three-game winning streak comes to an end.
Oh,
a bunch of home runs. Two for Brett Gardner. Two for Aaron Judge, who has 12 on the year. Most
right,
major
so
Judge on fire. Now it's
time
for StatCast.
Marlins.
Powered by AWS, Atlantic Heroes, and MLB Tonight post-game show. We're going to take you back to Fenway. This is our showcase event for most of the country. Hanley Ramirez.
Sorry, I stopped when you said
like
the
sorry,
don't
worry about it.
Was nice. One of two home runs on the evening for Hanley.
You got the prices?
Yeah.
All of them?
No, 15 is the highest.
the Monsters Brew.
Oh, here we go. Second one. A little better.
442. Message, see if Wawa Paulie's awake.
For those of you watching the action there in the Bronx, see if you can look.
Yeah.
Caught up one down between Manny Machado and the Boston Red Sox tonight. Manny was not happy. Much more on the big topic in baseball this night. Next.
What? I can't hear you.
Is powered by AWS.
Jess, I can't hear you. Jose Tavares, Refractor Auto. Jose Tavares, Refractor Auto. For Dunleavy.
When you booked this trip, you didn't know we had over 26,000 local activities listed on our trip. A few weeks ago, you still didn't know if you were going to go. Now the only thing you don't know is why it took you so long to come here. Expedia. Everything in one place, so you can travel home better.
We're here in the summer graveyard to demonstrate a remarkable car model. Newton, the wonderful car model. Simply wipe it on and just wipe it off. It's that easy. And look, we finished this sort of deep and shine even to a weather-beaten car. We polished this motor with Newton.
Don't sweat it, B-West. We figured it out. Figured it out. I'm going to start having you over every friggin' weekend, man. Help me sort, fire sales, everything. You're going to start coming down after work on Fridays. I'll get you a bed. I need the Angels, man. Brian, are you really? Yo, why don't you come down Saturday morning? Why don't you come down Saturday morning?
Thanks for your time. Last year in AAA, 93 games played, 19 home runs. So far this year, 24 games for you, 12 home runs. How do you explain the difference for you in 2017?
You know, approach for me, guys. I'm on a pretty good team, and I'm just surrounded by good players that keep having quality at-bats and put me in a good situation. So, you know, every time I get up to the plate, I got runners on, and, you know, they're making things happen. So I'm just in the right place at the right time.
Aaron, Mike Lowell here. Congrats to the hot start. When you say approach, is it a maturity that now you've seen a couple pitchers, or are you looking for a location or a pitch?
For me, it's about location and staying aggressive. You know, a little bit last year I was tentative and, you know, didn't go up there aggressive, you know, trying to attack my pitch that I can drive. And, you know, I was more see the ball, then swing instead of like, I know the ball is going to be where I want it and attacking it. So this year I'm just trying to stay aggressive and use the middle of the field.
Aaron, Pedro Martinez on this side. First of all, let me ask you, how does it feel to be that tall and that big?
I feel normal to me. I don't know. I don't know.
Man, you're one of the biggest boys I've seen in baseball. But listen,
I love Pedro. Joe Jimenez, purple paper to 250. We got an orange shimmer in here. Come on, boy. Friggin' Willie Adames. Orange shimmer, number 225.
A couple guys I've always watched the past couple
20
years.
20 out of 25.
Matt Holliday, Alex Rodriguez, you know, Stanton.
Why don't you come down Thursday morning, man? Friday I'm doing a bunch of stuff with the family, so why don't you come down Thursday morning?
I'm going to go out there and execute it. So, you know, I've kind of been leaning on Matty a lot this year and just, you know, asking questions. What he's thinking at certain counts? You know, runners on, nobody on. Like, what are you thinking? And, you know, a guy that's got a career batting average about 300 and almost 300 home runs. He's got a lot of good things to say, so.
Can you beat him in arm wrestling?
Oh, that'll be a good one. I think he's got me.
Really? Wow, that says something. You had two home runs tonight. The first one, you used the short porch in right. Why wouldn't you? Take advantage if you can. But the second one, you've had some great at-bats this year. A 10-pitch at-bat against Jason Grilli, and he kept coming after you. Walk us through that at-bat a little bit.
You know, I've never had success against Grilli, you know, in spring training or even times I faced him, I think, last year. And he's got a good fastball, like he said, 95.
Yep, number to a quarter, Forrest Whitley.
So for me,
Forrest Whitley, number to a quarter for the Astros.
You know, I kept fouling pitches off, and it was kind of elevating that fastball in the zone like he likes to do. And, you know, finally I was able to kind of stay back on a slider he hung in there and, you know, get the barrel on it.
You have a monitor that you can see what's on our screen right now, right, Aaron?
No, I got nothing.
Guys. Let me tell you this thing. I'm looking at a graphic right now. It says most home runs.
For the Dodgers, Andrew Sopko, four. LA Dodgers, going to Williams. Or going to Alfie, I'm sorry, going to Alfie.
1921. What do you think of that?
Yeah, unless you want to come down earlier.
I'm just blessed to be in the situation that I'm in.
Jake Bowers, 70th anniversary, blue.
That's going to be a fun year for all of us.
Alfie's got the Dodgers this time. Sorry about that.
I'm kidding, Aaron Judge. I am kidding. You are awesome to watch, my friend. Congratulations. And thank you for taking the time to join us. We
must see TV.
You must see TV. And if anyone says you are, you are.
I like it, guys. Thanks for having me.
Well, he's got the stoic thing going on. I like that he's on. He talks about his teammates. He talks about it's going to be a fun year. He's learning. Like, he looks like he's someone that wants to learn from guys who have had success. You know, when you point out Matt Holliday, it's because there's been talks and there's been, you know, analysis and seeing how everybody goes about their business. He wasn't happy with the 1.7 last year. He struck out half his at bats.
You know what I figured out when he was talking? When he described what Greedy had to offer for him. 95, right around 95, good breaking ball, good slider. He also went to the scouting report. Someone gave him every day to him the scouting report. And that says a lot about a young kid that could be beefy thinking about all the things that are getting.
He's really sick. I can't believe it.
Being the guy at the moment, he was beefy looking at the scouting report from everyone on the court.
He's all this. It's okay if he's busy with TV. We dig that. That was great.
I certainly did not believe going into this season. I was not a believer. Wow. Oh my God, what a catch by Colton Wong. Amazing. How'd you watch BP? Or did you just hear about it during the game? You know what, man? I started with Adam. I'm just ripping through.
Sincera SN250 tire with 3D Canyon Sight technology increases edges for enhanced all-weather handling, while the interlocking characteristics form a solid tread block for excellent dry performance. For true all-season grip, get the Falcon Sincera SN250.
Oh, I just bought a hybrid car, this Ionic that you see.
Who knew that it would be the perfect ride for me? It suits the fuel, it's at this cool, this baby really well.
Introducing the Hyundai Ioniq.
Nah, there's nine, but nobody's talking.
Giants, Dodgers, MLB Network's Wednesday Night Baseball, live at 10 Eastern.
It was your dad who taught you the meaning of hard work. He taught you to roll up your sleeves and get at it. He taught you to take pride in a job well done. But don't wear your dad's underwear. Gildan
wow.
Is designed for comfort and durability. For life in the 21st century. Step into your own. Your dad will be proud. The next generation of underwear. Gildan.
Why wait for the movies you want to watch? Check Fios first for new releases weeks before they're available on Netflix. Here's one now.
He's changing. Are you happy? I've never been happier. You know that girl, Kristen? I think you're the first woman who's tried to save him.
50 Shades Darker.
It's not on Netflix yet. It's already here, on Fios On Demand.
Giants, Dodgers, NL West rivals are at it again on
Tyler Stevenson, purple. Purple paper, number 250.
Their pregame stick with Queen, Seager, and Dodger Blue. MLB Network's Wednesday Night Baseball, live at 10 Eastern.
Welcome back to the Lion and Kugel's MLB Tonight postgame show.
I am starving. I could use a Papa Slam right now.
Jay! Bruce! Going the other way, Mike. Thank you. Yes, thank you. All right, 40% off. Jay Bruce hooking us up.
I need friggin' let Pujols. Let Pujols ship one here, and I'll give you an AO. Let Pujols ship one here, and I'll give you an AO. Justice Sheffield refractor.
slam of the year.
They're probably so happy they're getting 40% off.
Hey, this is a very different Astros team. I know they made a lot
Jesus
of
God.
Season, but this is a
strikes out with the bases loaded.
Team that lost, well, went 4-15 against the list show is hot. Back-to-back Papa Slams, which means you're going to get 40% off any regularly priced Papa John's pizza tomorrow when you use promo code
what a joke.
Papa Slam, which we know Pedro's ordering. Are you ready for it? Now, what is that called again, Pedro?
The meats.
The meats. Bring it on, boys.
Amazing. They've had runners all over the bases. And these crumbs can't score. For the Red Sox, Jason Groom, refractor auto, Sean Cook. Jason Groom, refractor auto, Sean Cook. Number to 499, 134 out of
499.
Congrats, Sean.
At some point, you're going to be on a Papa John's commercial. It is coming your way. Just be ready for that.
As long as we have the meats, I'm in.
There you go.
This guy's nuts, man, Pedro. I love it. This guy's crazier than I am. He really is. Could you imagine me and Pedro Martinez doing a show together? Oh, my God. Are you nuts? You got to be out of your mind. We'd have people on the ground rolling. He is hilarious.
He's Kevin Millar, ex-Big League. He's Chris Rhodes. Millar's best buds with some of the doing greatest. I'm Chris Rhodes. One world champ, one man. Intentional. We take the party to the NBA Network.
Oh my God. Bases loaded, one out, can't get a run in. I love it. Oh boy, I'll take a friggin' lead pipe. I will take a lead pipe.
There's no membership required with FitterX. It's totally free, and we don't use any personal promotion. FitterX has a guarantee of continuing your prescription.
Flawless basketball tomorrow.
Tell your doctor if you have a history of depression or suicidal thoughts, or if these feelings develop. Some people taking Otezla reported weight loss. Your doctor should monitor your weight and may stop treatment. Side effects may include diarrhea, nausea, upper respiratory tract infection, and headache. Tell your doctor about all the medicines you take and if you're pregnant or planning to. Ask your gynecologist about Otezla today. Otezla.
Chevy is the most awarded car company 3 years in a row. Yeah. Let's see what they can do to draw their award.
Oh, gosh. A lot of pressure.
You ready? Go.
2017
Motorsports Car of the Year.
Kelly Blue Book 2016 Best Resale Value. Place the biggest car hype to the 10 best global
2017 IIHS Top Safety. Only about 90 more to go.
2017 North American Car of the Year.
Cool award.
Cool award.
Damn, man.
Kugel's MLB Tonight postgame show. And Hanley on the line at Kugel's post-game report.
Hanley Ramirez, 5 home runs in your last 8 games. 2 tonight, no doubters. There was a lot to admire. So tell me about those 2 home runs tonight.
I mean, I try to be more compact with my swing, you know, I stay short, and it's not a little early, so I've been seeing the ball better.
Now, this team came into tonight's game last in the American League in home runs. A lot of talk about missing your good friend David Ortiz. What has been going on with the Red Sox power the first month of the season?
I think our pitching been dominated, you know, early in the season, so that's good. You know, I told those guys right there, you know, keep doing what you've been doing to the pitching staff. You know, we're going to get hot and we're going to try score some runs for you guys earlier in the game.
Now, Hanley, over the years you've competed against Chris Sale. What have you learned about him to have him now as a teammate?
How much competitive he is, man. It's unbelievable. You know,
Jake Lamb, purple to 250.
Ready to compete, and a great teammate.
Hanley, thanks so much. Congratulations.
Thank you.
So, the Red Sox are all smiles for good reason. They won the game. Hanley Ramirez with a couple home runs. You see what he did his first 14 games of the year. No home runs. His last 8 games, he's dialed in. Already with 5, starting to swing a bat that the Red Sox need. The biggest story of this game, which people will be talking about tomorrow, no doubt, Manny Machado has already been targeted by the Red Sox numerous times for a slide that he said was accidental into the leg of Dustin Pedroia, which caused him to miss a couple games. This pitch got Manny Machado really fired up. He went off after the game, starting with this interview with Gary Thorne.
Lost my respect for that organization in Boston and how they're handling the whole situation. And if they're going to hit me, go ahead.
David Fletcher, Blue, 70th anniversary.
Doing that, you know, I've lost mad respect for that team and that organization.
Did you expect that tonight?
I did not expect it at all. I don't expect anything when I go into the games. And, you know, first pitch goes out there, 98, but, you know, behind your back, I mean, what are you supposed to think?
Home run feels good.
Oh, always feels good.
Bonifacio, purple, number to 250.
Now what? I mean, what do you think? Where are we with this?
I don't know. I mean, we'll just have to find out tomorrow and see. They're probably going to try to hit me again, once again. So.
Wow, nice card. Brendan Rodgers, gold, 51 Bowman. 12 out of 50. Wow. Nice car for the Rockies. Elliot, congrats, man.
What do you think? Power stuff. I mean, that stuff that you don't do. But, I mean, I'm not on that side. I'm not on that organization. They're still thinking about that same slide that I did. That was no intention on hurting anybody. And, you know, I'm still paying. I'm still trying to get hit at. Get thrown out of my head. Thrown out everywhere. I've lost my respect for the organization, for that coaching staff, for everyone over there. I mean, if you're gonna hit me, go ahead. Hit me. You know, don't let them keep lingering around and, you know, keep trying to hit people. I hope you should do something about pitchers out there with balls in their hands, throwing 100 miles per hour, trying to hit people. That's bad too. I could go up there and crush somebody if I wanted to, but you know what? I'll get suspended for the year, and the pitchers only get suspended for 2 games. That's not cool. I don't know. That's not my call. I mean, I play baseball. That's all I can control. So, you know.
Hunter Renfro. Damn, Skripsky.
Somebody go ahead. Hit him. But.
Hunter Renfro. Nice one. RC logo.
That side on the other side. I don't know. I mean,
wow. What is this? I mean, it's number to 125. First time we've seen one. What is this parallel called? Angerman. Nice.
That guy couldn't get his point across without saying, yeah, 4-3
non-cut. Oh, he's pissed. I mean, he has every right to be pissed.
How can I be pissed? But he has
do you know how many times they've thrown in his head?
I do keep winning games out here, keep playing for my team, and that's all I can show. I mean, you never know what happens in Boston.
We're live in Studio 3. Mark Wohl, Hall of Famer Pedro Martinez. 2 different angles on this.
Can you make a fiver?
Right now,
yeah, if you don't mind, I got 4 piles.
Yeah, sure.
Packs.
I'm just gonna clean up the salad from 3 nights ago.
Oh, at least you're gonna do something.
Wow,
I love that you're breaking my balls. I mean,
I don't have much.
So I go out there, something happens, I'm gonna get suspended 10 games. This kid's going triple.
Brian says, what's up? Well, both Brian say, what's up? Angerman and West.
Hi.
West is coming down on Thursday.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. He's off Thursday through Sunday.
Wow.
The hard case.
Do I like them trying to retaliate for what they did to Pedro? Because if you're going to come into one of my stars, my face of the franchise, you better.
No, of course, for you sure. You had the same station on upstairs?
Yeah.
On the TV?
Yeah.
And I had the computer on?
Yeah.
And I cleaning up the table and I took the trash to the front door and all of a sudden I started bleeping out.
Yeah.
At first I thought it was you cursing and Facebook Live bleeping out. I didn't understand what was going on. And I kept bleeping out. I'm like, what the hell's going on? And then I saw the TV.
My high school Sharon was like,
wow. Anchorman. Just put you on Front Street.
Ooh. What do you say? You want to share it, or is it something you sit here and make a fire?
Angerman said that he's married to SCI, and Brian West said, I seen you cheat on SCI with another breaker.
Wow. Brian West. What is the quiet type?
Sorry, bro. Better check that invoice next week, Angerman. What's up, Brandon? What's going on, brother? How you been, man? Dateline, murder show. Yeah, I can't listen to that interview 25 times.
So what happened? People are throwing their head?
Yeah.
Who was he?
Who was he? Manny Machado. Not bad, man. I can't complain. I can't complain, man.
It's funny you complain to me all the time.
Oh, shut up. Wow. Lazarito Armenteros Blue Refractor. I sail so. Okay. Do you want to open the packs then, and I'll do
oh
that.
Oh God, I'm done. I'm just.
I sail Soto, 70th blue. They're not numbered. Thanks so much, honey.
You're welcome.
Really means the world to me.
I'm sure it does.
Yeah, they all go in there. They're all mixed up.
Oh, okay.
Unfortunately.
Oh, this is
a... Nick Gordon, gold, numbered to 50. Nice. You can't really tell on these.
One of the ones I sorted over the weekend.
I didn't even know you sorted.
Wow.
Oh,
look what's here. Why don't you tell the story about that?
Oh, wow. It is down here.
It's down here now. Where was it the other night?
How did I get down
tell
here
him
now?
Tell how angry you got.
I didn't get it. Listen to you.
Is Cook watching?
No.
Go ahead, tell the story.
Turn into a typical woman, man. Just convoluting stories and...
Oh, God. Come on, tell the story.
Somebody wait took my wine thing.
No.
Reese yes, Hoskins,
where's the beer
blue
opener?
Paper.
I don't know. I haven't used it. It should be in the drawer. I looked. Did you? Yeah, I looked. Okay, let me look. Let me check the other drawer. Let me use the eyes God gave me.
God.
It's not here. Maybe it's downstairs in the basement. You know, you had a bunch of cronies over the weekend.
It wasn't down here.
You guys drank about, you know.
It wasn't down here.
Two cases of beer. Yeah, where was it? Somebody took it home with them in their pocket. But
right,
it was my
I,
fault that I couldn't find it.
Oh, God. I didn't lose it. Speaking of Manny Machado, here we go. Orange paper, 20 out of 25. 20 out of 25. That has the experience, support
staff, and resources to seek the most. Can cut the sarcasm with a knife. So if you've suffered complications from hip replacement surgery, then the time to act is now, as you may be entitled to compensation. Some settlements are in effect. So call the number on your screen to find out if your device qualifies.
They've had 8 billion people on base. Nobody on 2 months and turns into a run.
This is all one break here?
Yeah. The Angels have had the bases loaded 1 billion. Yeah.
So you only did, you're doing
for the Yankees, Nick Solak.
3 cases.
Truex.
3 cases.
Base drunk.
And then only one hobby and 2 jumbo?
One hobby, 2 jumbo, yeah.
So hobby's the long one.
Yeah. Hmm. Still friggin' 3 boxes.
Yeah.
Oh, I hit a Tom Brady on it.
I saw.
You did?
Yeah, I was watching, and I heard you. You're very loud. I don't know if anybody's ever told you that.
Nobody on 2 outs to 2 runs. What?
Nothing.
Who are you shaking your head about?
You.
What about me?
Awesome.
Why are you laughing?
No reason. I can't believe you watch these shows. You know who that looks like? Oh my God. Tell me who you think that looks like.
Jackie Glazdale.
No, not her. The guy.
Oh.
Where do you see the guy? Just wait. Somebody in the group. Get ready.
I can't see what you're leaning across.
I'll tell you when you can grab that.
Oh.
come on, where is he?
Yankees win!
Wow, you got 16 cups of coffee down there.
Alright, so take them upstairs. It's not a big deal.
Down to our
skivvies.
Rips open and he comes in with a gun. The last thing I remember is her cry.
This lady's talking about skivvies and everything else.
And points the gun at us. And I don't know, maybe I passed out from fright. Maybe, I don't know. I have no recollection of the rest of the night.
Yeah, you're a therapist.
I'm a therapist.
Put me in therapist for a moment. What do you think?
I think there's probably some abuse. I really do. I never thought that I could block anything out, but the mind can do serious things when you're scared.
Floyd denies there was any abuse and claims Jennifer never even stayed over at their house. Spring of senior year, everything changes for Sharon Marshall. Her hopes of attending Georgia Tech are dashed when it becomes obvious to all she's pregnant.
I was flabbergasted, you know, just like, what? And she told me that she had been dating this guy and that they got pregnant. So I said, well, what about Georgia Tech? And she said, Daddy won't let me go. And she was just very upset, very crushed.
This young woman was with so much promise, so smart. Did you ever ask her why she got pregnant?
Yeah, she said it was an accident. I don't think it was. I think it was her way of trying to get away. And I think it was purposeful so she could maybe get married to somebody else and leave.
After graduation, practically overnight, Sharon and Floyd pull up stakes and move to Arizona. Sharon writes Jennifer to say they put the baby up for adoption.
But I don't know that they ever found record of any of this. Mm. We don't really know.
There
we go. I don't know what happened. Freaking
ganglion cyst.
But in 1987, Jennifer says she receives one last phone call from Sharon, out of the blue.
Justice Sheffield, orange chrome, numbered to 25.
And a very strange
17 out of 25.
Voice, very deadpan voice. She said, I want you to come visit. Daddy says you have to be here. You need to come
Daddy
visit.
Says.
Yes, Daddy said. And I knew something was wrong. Really, really wrong.
Ha!
There was something in her voice that was telling me, don't come. Don't come.
come up here. You know, Daddy's making me say this. Do not come. And
did you ever sense he was nearby?
Yes. He was in the background saying, you know, we'll find a way, sneak out, you know. Later, talking with...
Who's actually here?
They really feel like had I gone up there that I wouldn't...
Who is actually watching?
He would have killed me. I knew too much.
Because Franklin Floyd did not like losing.
Coming up, instead of studying aerospace engineering in Georgia, Sharon is now a stripper, an exotic dancer in Florida.
Wow.
We'll drop her off and he'll wait in the parking lot all night long when she works. She now becomes a stripper. She ends up going to parties.
Louis Urias, number 499.
And Franklin Floyd's dark side just keeps getting darker.
We started to see that Franklin really was off kilter.
Jalen Miller for the Giants. Jalen Miller for the Giants for Troy.
He's going to murder someone.
Introducing Always MyFit. Find the number that's right for your flow and panty size on the top of any Always pack. The better the fit, the better it protects. Always.
I think you promised my little girl a fabulous garden party for her birthday. So, I mowed the lawn, put up all the decorations. I thought I got everything.
Almost everything. You know, 1 in 10 houses get hit by a septic disaster and a bill of up to $15,000. But for only $7 a month, RIDEX is scientifically proven to break down waste, helping you avoid a septic disaster. RIDEX, the number one brand used by septic professionals in their homes.
Moms deal with lots of labels. Some people say jarred baby food with nothing artificial is impossible. But we know that it can be done. Because whether you're a mom, Mr. Mom, or one of your left in the fridge mom, everyone can agree that real food with simple ingredients can never be wrong. Let's turn the labels around. Feature or label of your love. Try our new puppies and puppies next, too.
We're going to put the truth by your puppies.
What's the subject?
I think the first one out is Donruss Classics. I like the product too. It's not expensive, and it's got good chase cards.
Thank you.
1986, when Sharon Marshall is in high school, no one knows that the man posing as her father is, in fact, Franklin Floyd, a federal fugitive on the run.
Wow.
When she gets pregnant during her senior year.
Abraham Gutierrez for the Braves. Abraham Gutierrez for the Braves.
2 years later,
refractor, number the 499. You listening to this, sicko?
Second baby, Michael, who plays a tragic
see you, Brian.
This unfolding tale of kidnapping and murder. And the girl who wanted to study aerospace engineering is now working in a strip club.
Wow.
Tampa, St. Petersburg, Florida. Late summer, 1988. Warren Marshall, Sharon, and her six-month-old baby boy, Michael, are living in a trailer park in Pinellas County. Warren tells everyone he's an ace house painter, but he's not the one bringing home a paycheck.
She's the breadwinner. I mean, he's claiming he's got a bad back and he can't paint.
It's Sharon who's supporting the family by working long shifts, dancing nude at the Mons Venus strip club.
Dancing nude.
She would walk in impeccably dressed.
Wow, for the Giants. C.J. Hinojosa. Purple refractor. Troy is raking. Number to 250. Congratulations, Troy.
Heather Lane is a dancer at the club when Sharon first shows up there for work.
Sharon was not a lewd dancer. Everything she wore was lacy, white blues, white kinks. Like she was trying to hold on to her innocence, really. That's what it looked like. And she did. She looked like a little doll.
Ew.
But Heather says the innocent-looking little doll had a father who wanted to watch her dance nude.
And I would imagine the strip club, you see all kinds of things.
Yes.
But not a father watching his daughter perform.
Correct. It's highly unusual. It actually was repulsive to the managers, the bouncers, and to the owner. They all said no. So when she would go into Mons Venus to work, he would sit in the parking lot in the car.
The whole time?
The whole time. We're talking 10, 12 hours a day.
AJ Puckett, blue paper, number 2, 150.
She had to leave with him.
One night, Heather says she learned of something even more sinister about Sharon and Floyd's relationship.
Eloy Jimenez.
She finally admitted to me he is not really my dad. He's my stepfather. And he had been molesting me and raping me most of my life. He's not doing it anymore, but he did do it for a long time. And I said, you know, you have to get out of this relationship. This is very dangerous for you, and it's sickening. It's sickening for all of us to see.
And she said?
She said, please don't tell. He will kill me. You don't understand. He will kill
me. All right, guys, last box mojo.
There's another reason Sharon feels she can't leave. Her six-month-old baby, Michael.
Who is watching, guys?
There's also this element of we now have the baby. We now have Michael. And Michael is in Franklin's possession all the time.
I'd love to know who's watching, because if nobody's watching, I'll do this in the morning when there are actually people watching. Why would you guys hang out here and not talk? Guys just sitting around waiting to hear your name?
Responsible
like we got a red. Okay.
It's at this point a new face shows up at the strip club in Tampa.
Just tell me what you need and I got you, man.
The scrap shop nestled pistol. What's the look like? Beautiful young lady cut out. She was sleeping, like 18, 19 years old. She's wearing the hairstyles from the 80s.
She's has a big head. She had the breast implants. She was living the life of a young adult.
Tragically, Cheryl Comesso falls prey to Franklin Fluker.
Where is it now getting involved with Cheryl? You know, he takes Cheryl and Sharon to isolated places to do them. It's kind of semi-pornographic. And he's not Cheryl to really do some of this because he supposedly told her that he had an end of slavery magazine.
As I saw her, I said, what do you think you're doing? This guy can't get you in Playboy. He can't do anything. He is just after you. There's something wrong with him, and you need to stay away from him.
Tensions between Cheryl and Floyd erupt one night in a loud confrontation right outside the door.
That was the last time I saw Cheryl. When Cheryl didn't show up, I thought she was so afraid that she went home to stay with her.
Cheryl Comesso goes missing, and within a day, she has Floyd and Sharon and Michael leave camp and disappear.
Coming up, flash forward 7 years.
Wow.
Investigators finally have a positive ID.
Good question.
Jane Doe I-275. The remains of a female murder victim found along a highway in Pinellas County.
Oh, nice. That's a good card. Benintendi, gold paper. Number to 50. 39 out of 50 for Cook.
I'll believe it might be a victim from this area.
The victim was Cheryl Comesso.
Brian Mundell. Red 70th anniversary.
Franklin Delano Floyd to death row.
I have to think about that. I would have to think about that. Who do you think, Noah?
Very similar. Until you take a closer look at this one. Salon Pass pain relief patch. Salon Pass isn't just the first. It's the only FDA-approved.
Wow. Holy God. Wow. CJ Hinojosa, Orange Shimmer. Are you kidding me?
Salon Pass, the strongest labeled pain reliever available without a prescription.
Are you kidding me?
Relief you can feel. Salon Pass for tough pain.
You know your heart loves Mega Red Omega 3s.
Troy, you are having a huge break, buddy.
Your brain.
18 out of 25.
Really love them too.
Orange Shimmer.
Introducing Mega Red Advanced 4-in-1. Just one soft gel delivers the omega 3 power of two regular fish oil pills. So give your body Mega Support with Mega Red Advanced 4-in-1.
I don't know much about him yet, no. I haven't really had the time to study these guys.
You have a life and you have ambition, but rarely do the two get along. No one knows that more than Capella University. It's why we've reshaped online education so adult learners can have both. With online learning formats that offer structure for those who need it, or more flexibility for those who don't. Because we think you deserve a better way to reach your potential.
How old is he?
You deserve to live and learn. Visit capella.edu today to find a learning format that fits your life.
You inherit lots of traits from your family. My ancestor, Lady Beatrice, introduced the Elizabethan ruff. Great-grandfather Horatio went west during the Gold Rush. And Aunt Susan was a world champion. I inherited their can-do spirit.
Ah, man. Unfortunately, we wasted a red on a non-auto for the Brew Crew. For Migsy. Damn. Louis Ortiz, 1-5. I wish I had Incarnate for you, man. Oh, wow. That's really weird, William.
If you have an infection in the treatment area. Kyvella can cause nerve injury in the jaw, resulting in an uneven smile or facial muscle weakness and trouble swallowing. to tell your doctor about all medical conditions, including if you have had or plan to have surgery or cosmetic treatments on your face, neck, or chin, have had or have medical conditions in or near your neck, or have bleeding problems. Tell your doctor about all medicines you take. The most common side effects are swelling, bruising, pain, numbness, redness, and areas of hardness in the treatment area. Save $100 on a treatment. Learn more at mykybella.com.
Gavin Lux, Orange Paper. Wow, this case was really good.
That I stumbled upon Talkspace.
16 out of 25.
Perfect therapist. She makes me think in the best way possible. This has been a life-changing experience.
Join more than 500,000 people who already text their therapist wherever they go for only $32 a week. Join now.
All right, guys, that was the first case.
Talkspace.
Sorry.
You can send your favorite photos as real postcards direct from your smartphone.
Hey, Mom.
Yeah.
Are you working on the 424 Excel sheet?
Simply choose your photo, write a message.
No, why?
And tap send.
I was just looking at
so quick and easy.
Mouse and email about
the very next day.
And it said,
go ahead.
Recovery.
Someone you love.
The things. Now there's two. I just want to make sure you
did.
Open it.
Yeah, I did. I opened both. I want to see the old code.
Okay.
Yeah. Well, I want Paul to the reason he didn't get back. He was in accident.
I will. She's family.
What?
I messaged Wallace Paul. He said, message Wallace Paul.
Yeah.
He said, there's a reason I didn't get back to the job and check my timeline. I checked his timeline. He's in the accident.
Oh.
Yeah.
Cheryl Kamesa's
what?
Disappearance. Ward and Sharon Marshall also vanished from Florida. And on June 15, 1989,
go ahead, Cook. Keep typing.
A man calling himself Clarence Hughes, married to a very young man, Tanya Taylor. Why did you marry?
I'm getting ready for that.
All right. What's up, Greg? A nap.
Mary Dufresne and her husband have been looking to adopt, and soon find themselves face to face with Franklin Floyd, or rather Clarence, along with Tanya and Michael.
They didn't look like they should be together. She was cautious when she was around him. Michael was her world, a little boy.
Did they seem loving at all?
Not at all.
Couple?
Not at all. That's what scared us. And then we found out later that they got married right before they met with the attorney so that he could sign the papers for the legal adoption. So he is listed as the birth father, even though he's not.
Who the birth father is remains a mystery to this day, possibly a boyfriend of Sharon's from Tampa. But in early August 1989, Sharon gives birth to a healthy baby girl. The Dufresne's named the baby Megan. And immediately afterwards, her birth mother and Floyd disappear once more.
So they leave New Orleans, then they go back to Oklahoma, to Tulsa. Now, her life becomes utter hell.
Few minutes.
Whereas when she was in high school, he did, in his own way, care about her. He was proud of her. Now she means nothing to him, other than someone that's going to support them.
Clarence Hughes, Tanya, and baby Michael surfaced in Tulsa, Oklahoma, the fall of 1989, living in a trailer park. When Karen Parsley meets Tanya at the Boatwright Strip Club called Passions.
Initial impressions of
her. She was really nice, friendly. Like, she danced with me at first to kind of get me comfortable. We were kind of on the same level. I'd gone to college, and she was smart.
But Karen says she begins to see signs of trouble.
Bruises started showing up. She has severe bruising, and I fell down the staircase. They lived in a trailer.
What kind of bruises?
Huge bruises, like on the back of the legs, the arms.
We talked to people who worked with her when she worked at the strip club, who say she would come to work with bruises on her body, bruises on her leg. That she says you put on.
No, sir.
You never
hit. No, sir. Never. I wouldn't hurt that darling for nothing.
That's what you call it, darling.
That's exactly what she is to me, sir. I raised her. I loved her then. I love her now with all my heart. All right? I did not abuse her. She was not brought a complaint against me for any reason. Never.
But based on what Tanya's co-workers have told author Matt Birkbeck, he believes she was finally ready to take two-year-old Michael and escape.
She's thinking about leaving him. She's thinking about her life. Floyd tells her one night they're having an argument, and he proclaims to her that Michael is mine. That's the night she decides she's going to put in motion a plan to leave him.
Later that same night, a woman's body is found lying along a service road on the outskirts of Oklahoma City.
The body's moving, but she's not weak. And so they call an ambulance, and the police had determined that there was likely a hit-and-run accident.
She's alive, but unconscious. EMTs arrive and take her to the hospital, where Clarence Hughes is summoned to identify her as his wife, Tanya.
Yeah, I think it's right, Cook. I'll check again when I get upstairs. I don't know. I'll check when I'm upstairs.
Then the hospital knew that we cared, so they let us in. So that's when they were watching me with her, and she was slowly moved toward me.
Maybe,
you know, heard my voice.
I don't know, man.
And so then that's when they confided that there's just something not right.
What do you mean?
That they felt there was stuff.
What do you think?
She didn't have a mark on her. She had no gravel. Even like where my uncle would get her. And if they were telling her, she this might have been in trauma of an accident.
The EMTs responded to the scene, said that it didn't look like a hit and run. She should have had skid marks where the vehicle knocked her for a good bit of distance. And it more like she was hit in the head.
Struck with the weapon.
Yes.
Tanya lies in a coma for 5 days. Then on April 30th, 1990, she's declared dead.
In autopsy. Oh, man. Noah, you know what, man? I am, I'm kind of out of it, to tell you the truth. I mean, if I had a pick from this set, I'd probably choose Rutherford. Or Senzel. But I'm not really going out on any kind of limb there. Man, I hate some of these.
Even mentioned to some of her co-workers that he had done something so terrible that he never came to the line of bed. He's supposed to have to do with murder of Cheryl.
Her friend
Cheryl, you're right. And I think that he was afraid that she was going to give him up on that, too. Because it really bothered her.
What happened to Cheryl? How did she die?
She got run over. You didn't know that?
You didn't kill him? Because there are many people in law enforcement who suspected you killed her.
Well, let me ask you this. Have I been convicted of killing her?
Jake Thompson, Purple Paper. Dom Smith, 70th Blue.
things wow. too seriously. But you can't be serious with Twizzlers.
How did you grow so many tomatoes?
With nature's care. They have organic soil and plant food. Guess how many are in there?
378.
Nope.
Nature's care. Grow more good stuff.
Oh my god.
Who's yours, though? Is still Daz? Kuna again for the Bravos. For Alfie.
Seduction is so tense, so frightening. It could only have been written by a madman. The newest and best women's murder club, 16th Seduction. At Southern New Hampshire University, we traveled across the country to celebrate the success of our online students who couldn't attend graduation.
Thank you guys for giving me the chance again. It's something that I worked for a long time.
Cook, are you still here?
Student success. A success worth celebrating.
Who did you get this degree for? I got it for me.
I did this for Mama.
I did it for you.
Lourdes Gurriel. Lourdes Gurriel for the Blue Jays. Refractor Auto for Philip. Number to 499.
Introducing Walkabout Wednesdays. It's our best deal ever. Tender, center cut sirloin, or chicken on the barbie. Fries, a draft beer, or a Coke. All for just $9.99. Only for a limited time. So don't walk. Run to our back.
Oh my god.
Wow. What if you could lose fat in just a few hours?
I don't know what's there. I'm just shocked.
You can with Sono Belly.
It seems no matter how much you work out or diet, there are parts of your body that just don't seem to change.
I went to the gym, I worked out at home, I bought videos. Man. No matter what I do,
kills my friggin' wrist.
With its advanced micro-laser technology,
Sono Belly gently removes that targeted fat and shapes your body for life-changing results.
With over 100...
So was the number right the first time?
Sono Belly is the largest and most experienced group practice in the U.S.
Sam ain't believing. I don't know what is.
After 5 years trying to get rid of that roll of fat,
oh, Sono why?
Call for your free, no-obligation consultation today and get $250 off your...
I must have screwed that up.
Payment plans are available.
Call 888-378-2385.
Couldn't have been. I mean, I don't know.
Wednesday.
Eric Westerman.
Maybe we were both off.
For killing Tim Gray in a jealous rage, his mom is convinced he didn't do it. Eric's confession to the police was coerced.
He told this girl he that's what I'm doing.
They said Eric was jealous. He wasn't anything like that.
I'm about to go one-on-one with Eric Westerfeld. The prosecution painted you as a jealous stalker type.
No.
But if you're not being truthful, tell me now.
Reasonable Doubt, all new Wednesday at 10, only on Investigation Discovery.
Louis Carpio. Louis Carpio for the Mets. For Philip.
The bizarre succession of events that sends Franklin Floyd to death row begins here. At an elementary school near Oklahoma City. It's here that Michael Hughes, now 6 years old, is enrolled in first grade. 4 years after his mother was killed in a suspicious accident, Michael is thriving.
He's living with the foster family for several years, a very loving family in Oklahoma, and they did wonders with him.
Now Michael has a chance at a good life.
He does, but Floyd serves the time he's been given for the parole violation, and he's released.
Once out of prison, Floyd goes to court to try and get custody of Michael.
Takes a DNA test and proves he's not Michael's father. Goes to court, says I raised him. Court says no. So he loses any parental.
So Floyd takes matters into his own hands. On September 12, 1994,
Drew Jackson refracted a 499.
He walks into the principal's office, shows me that he has a gun, and tells me he wants him to take him to Michael's classroom. They take Michael out, and they get into the principal's truck. He transports him to a wooded area. He duct tapes the principal to a tree. And he took Michael.
Walker Buehler, purple, number 250.
You find the truck in Dallas, so cross state lines. Now the FBI gets involved.
The FBI circulates a picture of Michael and hopes someone might have seen him after his abduction. On November 10th, 1994, Franklin Floyd is finally taken into custody for good. In Kentucky, when he tries to renew a driver's license under one of his known aliases.
Searching his apartment, would come up with a bus ticket from Atlanta to Louisville. Little boy.
What inning, Noah? Stanton, blue paper, number 150.
Was revealed to
Martes, refractor, number 499.
Susan's mother had briefly been married to Floyd using an alias when he absconded with a six-year-old. Back then, authorities refused to file a missing persons report because Floyd was technically her stepfather. It's 2014. Megan Dufresne finally learns her birth mother's true identity.
You're the one person who we can talk to, who is a part of her.
Nader, blue paper to 150.
We've asked so many other people. You think she wanted to run?
Yeah, absolutely. I think that he had the advantage getting her at the age that she was. brainwashing can be really powerful. He won in that game. I think as she was getting older.
Sandy Alcantara refractor auto number to 499 for Baldini. I mean, Baldini.
It's amazing how strong she was and selfless.
In the wake of this revelation, Jennifer, Sharon's closest friend, decides it's time to meet the daughter that Sharon gave up for adoption in New Orleans.
I found out, you know, in the early 2000s that she had had a daughter, and I daydreamed about finding her. Hi, I'm Jennifer. I wanted to...
Go to bed now, you sicko. Kyle Lewis, 70th Bowman. Blue refractor. Oh, wow, there's the auto. Slid right out. Look at that. AJ Puckett for the Casino Royales. Jeff Simmons.
Oh my gosh, you look so much like her. To look at me and see Sharon and see happiness and not see the news stories. And it all happened at once and it was great.
Today, Megan is in graduate school. And like her mother, an academic superstar.
What do you think Sharon would think of this home?
Oh, she would be so proud. Megan has become everything. To a T, everything that Sharon wanted to be.
She is the dream.
She is the dream. She is Sharon set free all over again.
Now that they know Sharon was born Suzanne Marie Savakis, her daughter Megan, her friends, and author Matt Birkbeck are getting her a new headstone. Meanwhile, Megan is now in touch with her mother's family, and her mother's friend Jennifer has become part of Megan's new expanded family.
Hello!
From this tragic story.
For my main man,
please join us next time.
D-Tizzle, baby! The Yankees win! The Yankees win! Gleyber, blue joint. 82 out of 150.
My grandmother, Lucille Johnson, she liked to spend one-on-one time with her grandchildren. Mom was a widow. She read the scriptures, she taught lessons in church and Sunday school.
Here comes Jess to yell at me and probably tell me to keep my voice down.
Her and her husband had got into the radio business and owned some radio stations.
She was 78 years old. She was very well respected.
I would call Mom every single night. I got home between 8 and 9 o'clock at night.
What's up, Neil? Just pulled a Gleyber blue.
No
answer. Arroyo. A bunch of Arroyos. Not a bunch, I'm sorry. One Arroyo, I can't remember what color. It's been good. First case was solid, man. Real solid. This is the second jump. This is the first jumbo. I did the hobby. Hobby's vicious to break, man. Vicious. Really vicious. I can't even remember, man. I'm so burnt out from looking at these cards. Tyler O'Neill, blue chrome to 150. I can't even remember what we pull. Seriously, it's crazy.
With every ring of the phone, the pit in Shirley England's stomach grows. She's been trying all morning to reach her mother.
Kevin Newman, red 70th paper.
Lucille, still spry at 78. Has been living on her own since the passing of her husband, Howard, some 2 years ago. Mom said to me, she said, Shirley, what would you do if you called and I didn't answer the phone? I said, Mom? I pulled up in the driveway, and as I was coming up, I noticed a lot of little kids' toys. I thought, whoa, what is this?
I had to use my key to get in, which was nothing different. There was a light on the outside. Kind of a strange thing.
In America.
Mom was pretty careful about electrical bills and very frugal.
Envenomed by the spider's lengthy venom-tipped fangs, the cricket is quickly immobilized.
Did you guys see Arenado's play there? He like was yawning. Rocket to first.
Yeah, buddy. He's a beast.
Oh, he's my number one player in the game. He's my number one. I love Mike Trout, but there's something about his defense that I value as well.
Just don't jinx my player.
Remember? Oh, is your player too?
Oh, remember?
Oh, yeah. Okay, I Nolan Arenado is not my number one. No,
hey, he's mine.
Yeah, he's Pedro's 5-1.
Don't steal my player from me.
Hey, you know, this guy's pretty good, Manny Machado, and he was not happy because of that pitch. When we come back, yeah. Bob Nightingale was there at Fenway Park talking to all the big characters. His report next.
Nothing on TV. As usual, my original thought was correct. Trevor Cahill. Mowing him down. That's good. Guy's going crazy. Seven strikeouts. Louis Almanzar, refractor auto for the Padres, number to 499. Louis Almanzar. Introducing Nissan's new Midnight
Edition. At Burger King, every day is deal day with the King Savings menu. Get three fluffy pancakes for
133 out of 499.
329 or 10 golden nuggets for $1.49. The King Savings menu, all day, every day, only at Burger King.
Tyler J, Blue Shimmer. Tyler J. Wait. Oh, yeah, that's right. They're not numbered. Forgot.
The Corona can always finds its beach. Working Out with Sasquatch.
These are the pillars of Working Out with Sasquatch. Hello, I'm Carl Anthony Towns, professional tall athlete. If you like workout things, do this workout and eat Jack Link's jerky.
Jack Link's jerky, a protein pack, snack packed with protein.
Let's go.
We're not coming out.
Josh Akame. Josh Akame. Purple. Number 250 for the Red Sox. Going a cookie. What's up, Robin?
It is a 13-3 run by the Jazz, chipping away at this deficit. And by the way, tonight's officials, Mike Callahan, John Goble, and David Guthrie. Replay official in Secaucus is Kane Fitzgerald, and they are part of the 30 NBA referees selected for this second round of the conference semifinals. There were 37 in the first round. There will be 20 for the conference finals and 12 for the NBA finals. Advancement to this round by season of first round performance, Kevin, in case you're wondering. Analytical data and ratings by coaches, GMs, or referee management is how they arrive here. Just in case you're wondering.
I was wondering. Now I feel I know a lot about the official. Thanks very much, Brian.
It's a Mr. Mac league, and for an official, it is sort of that way as well in how they perform on the analytical data for me. Sounds like a Trujillo's foul grabbed by Hayward. So, Kevin, this nice little run here by the Jazz. They scored the last 5 points of the first half, and now they've started the second half. Said he wanted to get things a little more organized and start to play the way you have to beat Utah, which is what?
North-south. They were going east-west.
Woo! For the Reds. G-Unit. G-Unit. Base joint. Congrats, man. On the board, brother.
They make you dribble the ball, and they're, you know, they're just our very good defensive team, and you've got to attack them.
ESPN and ABC will take over for games 2 and 3. We'll be back on TNT in the series. Game 4, game 5, if necessary.
Juan Moncada, number 250. For the White Sox. Andy Ibanez refractor number to 499. Andy Ibanez refractor number to 499. Louis Almanzar, Red 70. Thank you. Wow, he's a huge man. Rudy Gobert.
Wow.
He's a big dude, man. Bregman blue paper number to 150. Tetsudo Yamada blue refractor number to 150. It's amazing how many runners they've left on base. You guys are being so quiet and making it brutal. You guys have no clue how brutal it is to break this shit. And you guys love breaking it and you can't even chat with me while I'm sitting here falling asleep. Tristan McKenzie. Refractor auto, number to 499. Andrew Sopko for the Dodgers. Going to Alfie.
I'm Dr. Kelsey McNeely, and someday you might be calling me an energy farmer. Energy lives here.
We are the elite of the elite.
Put your arms around my waist. You're like a giant airless gorilla.
Drugs work on our beach. We're lifeguards. We're not CSI Miami.
Gotta get some evidence.
Someone's coming.
Now we hide.
Ah, ripped off the wall, man. I should have used putty.
Monthly fee, and there's no minimum balance. You're all right.
Guys, we're going to finish this case up, and then I'll do the third case in the morning. Start at like 11 o'clock. Afternoon joints. I gotta go to the bathroom so friggin' bad after this box. There he is! He's in every case, Joe Musgrove. Refractor auto for Travis Mitchell. $4.99, numbered to $4.99. Joe Musgrove. I mean, I would assume so, unless somebody's listed as an SP. That's happened a few times. Eric Hosmer was one. I can't remember who else was a short, right? I don't remember if Moncada was listed as a short print, but there were other ones in that set with Hosmer. I can't remember who they were. Young World Baseball Classic for Korea, number 499. Yeah, I mean, I feel the same way. Girardo, blue paper, number to 150. Give me a minute, guys. I gotta run to the bathroom.
So far, you gotta give it.
How does he miss that? I guess a lot of traffic down there. Jorge Alfaro, rookie auto. For the Sillies. Going to Sean. Jorge Alfaro, rookie auto. Gold joint. Going to Sean. One of 50, the old eBay 101. Syndergaard purple, 250. What's up, man? Meja. Kyle Tucker, gold paper, number 250. Kyle Tucker, gold paper. Tyler Bead refracted to $4.99. Kyle Funkhauser for the Tigers. Kyle Funkhauser for Philip. Draymond Green stats, it looks like a friggin'. It's unbelievable. Jose De Leon for the Dodgers. Jose De Leon for the Dodgers. Alfie. Gold shimmer. One time, boys. Good luck. Eric Jenkins, number 250. Freaking crumb. 34 out of 50. Crumb.
2 points, 7 rebounds, 5 assists. McGee will sit as well.
And 23 assists for Golden State Warriors on their way to another 30 assist night, possibly.
James Michael McAdoo on the floor for Golden State.
Number to 499, Harrison.
And that'll take us to the end of the third quarter. Rodney Hood scores 10 in the quarter for the Jazz, but Curry and Pachulia, 6 apiece for the Warriors. Curry with 22, and the Jazz in front as we go to the fourth quarter.
There's either a gold shimmer. Or a super in that pack. I can't tell. I think it's a gold shimmer. It's close though. Freddie Peralta, Blue Shimmer.
We're proud to reveal that Jim Beam Black has been awarded the world's highest rated bourbon. Their words, not ours. Make history.
Back in Oakland, Oracle Arena, home of the Warriors, as we head to the fourth quarter. And moments ago, Lewis Johnson caught up with Warriors acting head coach Mike Brown. We've seen the offensive runs by you in this game, but defensively, your concerns as we approach the fourth quarter. Rodney Hood had 10 in the last quarter.
Yeah, Rodney got aggressive. We didn't do a good job on him, especially with him going to the rim. But they also had a couple of threes that where we left the guys in the corner, and we know we shouldn't do that.
All right, what's the key down the stretch here?
Well, we got to defend. We got to take the three out the game, especially with the Utah going down the stretch and us having a lead. And then we got to try to contain Rodney a little bit better.
All right, Mike, thanks.
Thank you.
B.A.? All right, Lewis, thanks. And our thanks to Mike Brown. Klay Thompson fires up a three. And there is Rodney Hood, the aforementioned, who posted 10 in the quarter. And Kevin, for Utah, you get 2 points in the quarter from Gordon Hayward. 1 of 6 shooting that third quarter. Yet you win the quarter on the points. 27-26 third quarter scoring. And down 12 at the half, Utah ends up down 11 to start the fourth quarter.
That's what you got to do. You got to win long stretches of the game.
Christian Arroyo, base. Christian Arroyo base for Troy. What a break, buddy. Congratulations.
Chelsea Lane on the bench. Curry has that ankle, that left ankle loosened up. Something to keep an eye on. I'm sure Mike Brown would love to see a burst by the Warriors and might not even have to bring Curry back. See if the Jazz have a response. Dial.
Jarrell Cotton for the A's, for the Oakland A's. Jarrell Cotton for William Nicholas. Tell me about it, man. I just want to know the hits. Where they are watching, they're just lurking.
So this was during the break, and very obviously a little bit of pain as Chelsea Lane trying to help him out over there. And I think that motion would say it was on that layup.
Yeah, it did. You can see him there. He's limping, coming back down. A little bit of pain is getting through there. So hopefully he's okay.
It's a good catch by our crew. Here's Rodney Hood. He's had the hot hand. And Favors couldn't keep it alive. Clark comes out of the pack. The former Utah Jazz player, undrafted out of Belmont. He's had a nice run. Gave him good minutes in the first round with two injured Warriors out. Draymond Green started to put some stakes down in this game. Late third, now early fourth. Green now with 16 points, 7 boards, 6 assists. 17-point lead just like that. Now inside to Favors. Shot clock at 4. Favors and Draymond Green just can't punch.
Jake Lamb, number to 499. Suarez, purple, number to 250.
We saw Favors.
Guy has been ice cold for months, man. You deserve it. 42 out of 50. Congratulations, buddy. You deserve it.
NBA.com, your premier source for NBA memorabilia.
Everyday card from American Express, you get cash back on purchases with no annual fee. It's more than cash back. It's backed by the service and security of American Express. Think of all this stuff, like snoring. Because you're
the NBA playoffs as TNT are brought to you by the 2017 Optima from Kia, official vehicle of the NBA, by State Farm, here to help life go right, by Coors Light, whatever your option, I'm on, and loaded with bacon and steak sauce. Try the new steak option in their bacon king sandwiches at Burger King today.
Beautiful Tuesday night here in the Bay Area, Oakland and Oracle Arena. And let's take a look at the smooth finish of the game presented by Gatorade.
David Fletcher, refractor number to 499.
Scoring 10 consecutive points for the Dubs. Steph Curry approves. Draymond Green, 2-for-4 from behind the arc. He has 16 points, 8 rebounds, 6 assists. And just like that, the Warriors up 19, now they get 21. After the timeout.
Chance Cisco, number to 499. Chance Cisco, number to 499.
Stretch up the 3-point line and back up. Just a great offensive team. Joe Johnson snaps a 12-0 run by the Golden State Warriors. And Joe Johnson in the double figures with 11 now. Getting the start tonight. He's been brilliant off the bench. Clark on the move. And there's Ingles with the rebound. Jazz started the game 0-for-6. They started this fourth quarter 0-for-6 from the field. And Warriors were able to cash in on the other end. Golden State started this game scoring the first 9 points. Gobert throws it into the first row. Turnover. Quinn Snyder, third year. First time the Jazz have been in the playoffs in 5 years. First playoff series win. It's 7 years for Utah. They had a run of 20 consecutive.
Jacob Hayward for the Giants going back to Troy. Unbelievable.
That is on the rise, a new entry into the postseason. Carl Malone, John Stockton. Tables on blocked. David West rising high, blocks the 3. Iguodala will back it out. Thompson a pull. Hill with the rebound. Now Jazz with that great run and starts this series with the Golden State Warriors. You know, the Jazz, during a lot of those years, running into the difficult Lakers club back when they were in the playoffs, 2012 and before.
Louis Erkeg. Lucas Erkeg.
8 out of 499. Somehow the Utah can get a little bit of a run here.
There's Thompson. It's a 2. Clay Thompson now is 17. Gobert with West on him. Approaching the 6-minute mark in a 20-point Warrior lead. And Dante Exum, his first playoff.
Ortiz, number to 499.
He is playing well. He had a good run in a couple of games in the first round against the Clippers, and he's had a nice run here in this first game of the second round. It does not look like he's
Morjan, purple, right away. For the Padres.
Good pass. Look at West. Get up. Clark tried to run. And it's looking easy right now for Golden State fans.
Says, I'm going to back cut, someone throw it to me, I'll lay it in.
Who is this young woman?
She's my... Matt Manning, purple.
She and I are working together, certainly.
Ah.
consists of them as
Prince, Dino Prince, rated PG-13. Experience it in IMAX 3D.
Chance Adams for the Yankees. Forward, DT.
Doubt is a drizzle. Just enough to make
bunch of tourist stuff. It's the best.
Yourself. Or quit. And let them have it.
Alright guys, last box mojo of the night. We'll do the next case in the AM.
This new test for me is it's got a half pound of beef, crispy bacon, steak sauce. It's just perfect for the jackpot.
Ching!
Steakhouse sauce, bacon, and crispy onion. Try the new Steakhouse King or the Beef King. Only in Burger King.
Good luck, everyone. Kopech Purple, number 250. Kopech Purple. Flaherty Purple Paper, number 250. Josh Akame for the Red Sox. Josh Akame for the Red Sox.
Yeah, they're taking a look at here.
Cookie.
Call the common foul. And they're just making sure it's not a flagrant as we put our table back together. Heck. Gave him a shove. I wouldn't say that was a necessary basketball move, right? But I... Shots of the ball here for Golden State. And
appreciate Mike Callahan coming over, letting us know the last part of the play unnecessary. That's right. The flagrant.
Actually, I disagree. Sometimes when you're getting beat, it's necessary to throw someone into the stands.
Oh, I see what you're saying.
I'm telling you. Unnecessary for who?
So the play called correctly in your mind, but also...
Jose De Leon for the Dodgers. Blue refractor. It's actually... I don't know what it is. Somebody 125.
Throw him in for a couple, you know, two possessions. They, I think they just let him rest on the way home. They'll have a little bit of that ankle soreness he has.
Might as well. The Warriors, their average margin of victory so far in the postseason is over 11 points, 11.5, actually. And they're going to add to that here tonight under 5 minutes we go. Rodney Hood, bullet pass to the foul boy, and he is on the board in the postseason. Joel Ballenboy. Weaver State, the rookie. Get some valuable minutes here. Where you can take him if you're Quince.
Fernando Romero for the Twins. Fernando Romero for the Twins. There you go, Noah. Waited long enough.
First game of the series. He's trying to take it in its own windows as it comes, and each possession and all of the cliches that work. But I think he understands and admitted that. But this is a series. We got to get used to the pace. Got to get used to the rhythm. They want to grind them out. Seven-game series. As Trey Lyles,
Reyes, number to 499.
You know, that's a big win for this
Sotko, number to 499.
They start to enter into a perennial playoff team, they hope.
Yeah. Could have a lot of stuff to look at here as a team. They'll go over their mistakes. They'll say, this is what we got to do better. And, you know, one thing I want to talk about is David West. That just goes to show how good this Golden State Warriors team is. I mean, David West is leading an assist with seven coming out the bench.
Draymond Green will head to the bench. He'll finish with 17 points, 8 rebounds, 6 assists. As you take a look at the rest of the schedule, ESPN Thursday.
All right, guys, here's your hit recap.
Weekend, we're back on TNT for Game 4.
Romero base. De Leon, a parallel to 125. Akame base. Adams base. Urseg, refractor auto. Hayward base. Gleyber, gold. Parallel. Jarrell Cotton. Arroyo. Eric Jenkins, gold shimmer. De Leon. Funkhauser. Kyle Tucker, gold paper. Alfaro Gold Auto, Musgrove Refractor Auto, Sopko Auto, Tristan McKenzie Refractor Auto, Juan Moncada Gold, non-auto, Senzel Base Auto, Akame Purple Parallel, Gleyber Blue, and Almanzar Refractor. Pocket Base, Alcantara Refractor, Drew Jackson Refractor, Caprio Base, and a Gurriel Refractor. Got one more pile. Acuna, Ortiz, Red, 105. Hinojosa, Orange Shimmer, number 25. Benintendi, Gold. Hinojosa, Purple Auto. Jalen Miller, for the Giants. Sheffield Orange Parallel. Nick Solik, base on. Manny, base on. Renfro. Gotta call you in the morning. Brennan Rogers, 51, gold parallel. Jason Groom, refractor auto. Sopko, base auto. Forrest Whitley, orange refractor. Man, I'm so tired. I don't know what the hell I'm saying. Willie Adams, orange shimmer. Jose Tavares, refractor auto. Acuna, refractor auto. Arroyo, gold auto. Willie Calhoun, orange paper. Jose Pools, blue auto. And then Eloy Jimenez, base auto. All right, guys, I will catch you tomorrow.